tonight on 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, Sarah Milligan, Joe Wilkinson, Tom Allen, Rosie Jones, Mr. Swallow, Susie Dent, Rachel Riley, and your host, Jimmy
Welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show about letters, numbers and conundrums. This is like normal Countdown, except we don't have to play by the rules, so I can do stuff like this.
Did you struggle to hit that at first?
I was going to go in there. I love that you noticed that.
You really hit the side and I thought, aww.
This is how you actually do it.
Let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's guest team captain Sarah Milligan. Sarah has spoken on stage about her IBS, so she's unique among comedians in that she doesn't just have funny bones, she's also got a funny tummy. And Sarah's teammate, Tom Allen. Look at him. You might recognise Tom from his previous work as host of Bake Off Professionals or as the default profile picture on Twitter. Up against them this evening, it's guest team captain Joe Wilkinson. Yeah. Joe Wilkinson, who says dirty hippie blokes aren't sexy? Women. Women say that. And joining Joe tonight, it's Rosie Jones. When Rosie's on television, I don't see a disabled person, and that's because I don't watch anything she's in.
Why that much mean that you don't watch TV, though? Because I'm on everything.
Sarah, what were you like as a teenager?
Very similar to this, really, just smaller boobs, bigger glasses. It was the 80s, so glasses were a lot bigger anyway. Mm. I once fell off my bike and we had to get auto glass out just to repair a chip. That's not true. I couldn't ride a bike.
Did you genuinely not ride a bike?
No. I had an imaginary library, Jimmy, and I had to keep that tidy. And it wasn't imaginary. The books were real, but nobody came.
Tom.
Yes?
Now, you're turning 40 soon.
I know. I can't believe it either.
How would you be celebrating?
Well, you know what, Jimmy? I've always seen myself as an older man trapped inside a younger man. Not literally. But as I get into my 40s, I might start getting younger. I'm hoping I might perhaps take up DJing, maybe I'll graph up a children's park. But knowing me, I'll probably end up just setting up my own business making scented candles.
What is your signature scent?
Sandalwood and sort of incense.
Have you ever smelt the inside of a tennis ball?
No, why would I have? Why did you cut it open?
The cup you keep your toothbrush in, worst smell in the world.
What cup?
Ooh. What cup? Because yours is just on a loose bit of string.
I'll just take it off the first guy.
That was always my favourite thing when I used to live in a shared house. I would always come into the communal kitchen and go, has anyone seen our toothbrush?
I'm the same, but with vibrators.
The idea of you living in a shared house is quite frankly ridiculous.
Yeah. Like a house full of robots.
Rosie, it says here you're a doctor now. Tell us more.
I got it for, like, being famous and dribbling and telling people that I am a natural doctor. And if they want me to, I will perform surgery on them as long as they pay me in life. burger and chips.
Joe, do you find it easy to make new friends?
Yeah. I'm very good at starting conversations with strangers, or even if they're clearly in a hurry. I'll give you an example. If someone's leaving their house, I might go up to them and as an icebreaker, I'll say, "That's where you live." Or, oh yeah, if someone's smoking, I might ask for a light, but I don't smoke personally, so I'll either light a candle or I'll start a bin fire. And then we'll just chat about that until they put it out.
Okay. Rosie, have you got a mascot with you?
Yes.
Excellent.
I've got a very busy and high-flying lifestyle. So to keep awake and alert, I tried all the drugs, all of them. No effect, apart from speed, made me able-bodied. So I thought I can't have that, cos I wouldn't have a career. But I've nailed it. It's what keeps me alert and sprightly.
Juice.
I got all the juice and it works. But one bit of juice, I'm hooked. So I started an underground business. What I do is I give out a little bit of free juice and then you get hooked and then you come back to daddy for more. Tom, I got a special.
Oh, that doesn't look like it's staying.
Are you ready to get hooked?
Oh my God! How is it so bitter?
Fucking Nora!
I've never had something so bitter. And I mean, have you met me?
Okay. Tom, have you got a mascot? What have you got?
Jimmy, yes, I've actually been getting very into gardening lately. I've started to really enjoy it. So I brought down some of my gardening equipment. Thought I'd put that on the desk. And and this as well, because I'd like to be able to say I'm just sat here chilling with my hose. And I thought that was very good. What I found is I have to go out because I have a terrible problem with slugs. And what they do, right, is they attach themselves to my bush and I have to go out late at night padding around in the bushes with a torch like some sort of gay in the 1970s. Except the only thing getting sucked off is my hydrangeas.
Sarah, have you got a mascot?
Every time I'm on this programme, I'm not very good at it. I'm not. So I thought maybe some kind of confidence-boosting compliments might be a nice thing.
Oh, that's a good idea.
So I bought this mirror that gives you compliments. Ooh. Now, it looks quite old-fashioned, but it's really quite modern because it gives you a compliment when you look into it. Are you ready for the...
Yeah, sure.
See if I can perform a bit better on the show. So this is...
Wow, Sarah, you look really bonny and dead clever.
It's quite good, isn't it? Really bonny and dead clever. And like a really alluring, sexy Geordie accent as well, I thought.
Could I have a go? Would it work?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, sure. Careful, okay. Tom, pass it.
Yeah, I won't look. I won't look at it. I won't look.
Okay.
That's very cute.
I'm sorry. No face detected.
Joe, have you got a mascot?
I've had a bit of a mare recently because I broke my my mug tree.
How did you break it?
Absolutely none of your business. So, yeah, I get a bit down if I haven't got a decent mug tree, so I tried to buy one, but they don't sell them anywhere. They don't sell them anymore. It's mental. So then I had to make my own, so I thought the only way I could think of doing it is I bought a load of male sex dolls and I took the groins.
What, sorry?
Think about it, Jimmy. How would you make a mug tree? I took the groins off four sex dolls and I nailed them to a fencing post. I'll be honest with you, I'm not that happy about it. Well, I'll tell you why, because you have to squeeze. You have to squeeze to get it on. And yeah, honestly, who's going to put their Jubilee mug on that? I don't want to. But they don't sell them anymore. They don't sell them anymore.
I believe you could buy mug trees on Amazon.
Oh. What a waste of penises. Okay, get rid of it then. Fabio, can you take away the button? Don't pull it by its penis, please.
That's really drawn your eye there, Rachel. That's real. They follow you around the room, don't they? I'm Joe Wilkinson, everyone. And over in Dictionary Corner, it's Mr. Swallow. Mr. Swallow, yes. What have you been up to since we last saw you?
Not much, to be honest. I did recently find out that I'm not vegan. What's the other one? Psychic. And the very, 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 very quick demo. Very quick demo, because I know we haven't got long. But, Jimmy, just say the first, I don't know, first country that comes to your head after the count of three. One, two, three.
Brazil.
Brazil. I missed the pin. Do you want to do it again? We can do it again. Any word that comes to mind after the count of three. One, two, three.
Banana?
Banana.
And with Mr. Swan, of course, it's Susie Dent. Over the years, Susie has introduced us to words such as gandalflanker, scurry funge, and thunderplump. What would we do without her? You know what? I think we'd manage. Susie, are there any words that sound absolutely filthy, but they aren't?
Yes, I told you about one of my favourites, which is coming tonight, but it's a mineral which was founded in, or discovered in, Cummington. But it is coming tonight.
Get Joe's mascot back, we might all be.
But there are lots of others, and I love them because the definitions are just sort of just as euphemistic. Wanker pin.
What's it?
A wanker pin. And great definition again. A flowering plant in the Central American wetlands.
Which is what I call my vagina.
And in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Yeah. Anything embarrassing happened to you lately, Rachel?
Well, on the way up, I got the train, and as I was sitting there, the next stop, a little old lady got on. She put the case down, and she found a place to sit next to me, and she got her tablet out, she put her headphones in, and she pressed play on an audiobook she'd been listening to, and she didn't realise that she hadn't actually plugged it in. And it was just at the moment where the girl got her hands grabbed behind her back at the wrist, and she was bent over something. And she was listening to old granny porn. But everyone on the train could listen to it because I had to give her the end of her cable and pass it to her.
Where did she get off?
I'm trying to work out a pun train session. Yeah. Fuck it, let's move on.
Stains.
Stains. Oh. Just... OK, the prize that seems to be competing for tonight is this, the Countdown Jazz Band Kit. Never had a lesson. OK, let's count down, everyone. Time for our first game. Sarah, Tom, you get the first pick of the letters.
Oh, here we go.
Consonant, please.
Thank you, Tom.
Pleasure. Treasure.
M.
And then a vowel, I think, a vowel.
A.
And then another consonant.
S.
And then another consonant.
T.
A vowel, please.
U.
Consonant, please.
M.
And then another consonant.
D.
A vowel, please.
A.
A consonant, please.
And lastly, R.
OK, and your time starts now. Oh, look at this. Lovely. I've done one of everyone because I had ages. I had like 30 seconds.
Yeah, yeah.
So I've done me. I've done Sarah.
Oh.
And it's. Oh. That's quite nice, isn't
it? Quite sassy.
Oh, it's very lifelike. Oh. I've done Rosie, which I think you're.
Oh.
Pretty good.
Isn't she sexy?
I've done Tom. Oh, I hope he doesn't fall off that bit. It's a disaster, won't we? We're never getting back together again.
Well, somebody knows the King's men.
And then I've done Joe as well. I think it's quite lifelike. I think you'll like this. There you go.
You've done me from underneath.
I'm gonna hand these out. Pass that along.
Thanks. Oh,
lovely. So there you go, there's yours.
Oh, that's like so nice. It's got pubes in it, hold on.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
It's got some pubes in it. Apologies about the smell, that's Joe's one's actually made from shit.
No way, kids.
What's happening?
OK, Sarah, how many letters?
Seven.
Seven. Excellent.
I know. I'm surprised as well.
Tom, how many?
Seven.
Joe, how many?
Four or a risky two.
Rosie?
I think I got six.
What's your four?
Rust.
Oh,
yes! Rust.
Okay. Rosie, you're six.
Dramas!
Dramas. Tom, you're seven.
Well, I feel like it's a bit sexist, but dustman. Can I have that?
You can, yeah, all one word.
I mean, anybody can be a dust operative.
Exactly.
Sarah, you're seven.
Mustard.
Mustard. A man's turn.
Well done.
Mr. Swallow, Susie, could they have done any better?
Seven was top. Wow. Well done.
OK, so, Joe, Rosie, you're to pick the numbers. Go on.
Oh, can we get one of them really big ones?
100,
please. A really big one.
Ask for 10.
Can we get a 10?
A 5.
A 5?
Hang on, I've got one more shot.
One's good, a 1's good. Yes.
Five.
Yeah.
Five.
Great.
Seven.
Yes.
Yeah.
One.
Yeah.
Okay, here we go.
634.
So your target is 634.
Shit.
Your time
starts. This is doable. This is doable.
Now.
Yeah.
This is doable.
Thank you. So the target was 6:34, Joe?
6:33.
6:33. Okay, okay, one away, okay.
I think I got 6:35.
Okay.
In did you my head.
Sure. Sarah, did you get it?
No, I'm one away.
Tom?
6:37.
So, Sarah, how did you get it?
6 multiplied by 100 is 600, 7 fives are 35, so 6:35, 10 divided by 5 is 2, so 6:33. So I couldn't get any closer than 6:33 or 6:35.
Yep, one away, well done.
I did that.
Yeah. You, sorry, one out, Rosie?
I did that in my head. Do you believe me?
Nope.
But I couldn't break work and not cut I got seven pulpos.
Well done,
you're the only person who can shout out, I've got cerebral palsy, and everybody goes, ah!
Joe, did you write it down? You were one away, right?
100 plus 5, that's 105, Rachel.
Yep. Thanks, Joe.
Times it by 6, good luck. Probably out of our debt.
It's around about 6:30.
Plus the 10?
6:40.
Minus 7, that is 6:33, Rachel.
Yep, it is.
Correct.
7 points to both teams. Rachel, you had one job.
You could have said 100 minus 10 is 90, times it by 7 for 630, and then add the two fives and take the 6.
Just noise. Oh.
And here is your teaser. The words are semi-tour. The clue is it's gone all soggy. That's semi-tour, it's gone all soggy. See you after the break. Welcome back, the answer to the teaser. The words were semi-tour, the clue was it's gone all soggy. It was, of course, moisture. Of course it was. So Sarah and Tom are in the lead. Time for another letters game. Joe, Rosie, your turn to pick.
Constant, please.
Yeah.
Thanks, Joe.
Yeah, a T.
W.
A T would be good. Vowel.
Yeah.
I.
A consonant.
Yeah.
Try and spell a word, otherwise I'm buggered. Yes!
N.
A consonant. D.
Mm. R.
Constant, please.
S.
Yes! A vowel, yeah.
E.
Yes! Oh, an N.
C.
Vowel, a vowel.
Vowel.
A.
A consonant. I've just written my name down.
L.
TV doesn't pay what it used to, so I've taken another job. all right, your time starts now. Who ordered a pizza? Did you order a pizza? I got pizza. Pizzas.
Is this how you would work if you worked for a delivery company?
Give them away as well.
Send them bottles.
Oh, great.
Jimmy, right. How are you making that look weird?
Like that.
It looks so uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Jimmy,
yeah.
Jimmy, it looks like the saddle's gone inside you.
I've never felt better. How many you got?
Pizzas.
Tom,
one each.
I've got 5. I feel
five?
Pathetic.
Rosie?
Okay. Oh. 6.
2, 3, 4, 5.
So Joe, how many?
6, I think.
Sarah?
6.
6.
Yeah.
I'm quite pissed off.
Go on, how so?
Mine's weird.
I think yours has got Nutella on it.
Why?
Well, try it. It's delicious, a chocolate spread pizza. Go on, try it.
Oh, that's lovely.
Do you want mine?
Oh, go on. Choo-choo! Is this going to take...
Get ready for some sexiness.
It's real. I don't know if it's real or the cerebral palsy.
Oh, no! It looks sexy.
What's your five-letter word?
Mine's pathetic. Laces.
Sarah, you're six.
Winces?
Winces or winces?
Winces.
Winces, yeah.
Oh, no. Oh, yeah. Oh, shit.
Oh, yeah.
Joe, you're six.
Scalar.
Oh, Scalar's in for six.
Scalar's in!
Yeah.
Rosie, you're six.
Well, I annoyingly also have winces.
Oh, did you write it down, though, or not?
Yeah. But when we got the pizza, I went for slicer.
Oh, that's very good.
Wonderful, wonderful.
Slicer.
Did we get the pizza after the...
Seven! Oh! Oh.
Go on, cry.
Okay, 6 points to both James. Mr. Swallow, Susie Dent, could they have done any better?
Yes. Well, another seven, quite a fun one, arsenic. and then an ear. Is that carlines?
Yes, they are thistle-like plants.
OK, at the end of that, Joe and Rosie have 13 points. Sarah and Tom are ahead with 20. Now time for Sarah and Joe to go head-to-head. Sarah, your turn to pick the numbers.
I'm going to say two big ones, please, Rachel.
5, 2, 4, 1, 25.
Yes! We're in with a chance, guys.
And the target, easy. 2, 3, 6.
Oh, well, let's see. Your time starts now.
This could happen.
Someone's had a panic attack. Joe, talk us through your mental crisis.
I thought it was going to be easy and it wasn't.
Joe, say you're doing it in your head.
Yeah, I've done it. You're just going to have to trust me.
You think you've got it. And Sarah, have you got it?
I'm one away. Always okay, one away. Away.
You do it.
I'm one away as well.
No,
you do it. You tell us how you did it, Joe.
100 plus 5.
Yeah.
It's 110. No, it's not.
I mean...
Do you know what it is?
I think it's 105.
Correct. Times that by two.
210.
Yeah. And then... What's left?
25 and a 1, Joe.
Oh, and a 20. times a 25.
One. No!
One.
No! Plus the 25... I'm one away, one away. Oh, plus one.
Ten points to Joe.
So can you just fumble your way through it after the music stopped? Is that a thing, is it?
That's my whole sex life.
Are you doing musical chairs, but with your cock?
In a manner of speaking, yeah, sure. So Sarah and Tom have 20. Joe and Rosie have 23.
Yeah!
OK, time now to go across to Dictionary Corner. Mr. Swallow, what have you got for us?
Yes, thank you, Jimmy. So, since first appearing on this show, which I must say, by the way, I am eternally grateful for, but I still don't really know what it is, a lot of people have sort of got in contact to ask about some of the memory demonstrations I've done on the shows in the past, like memorising a deck of playing cards, memorising the Wagamama menu and so on. and the truth is, a lot of these techniques are very straightforward to learn if you put, you know, the time in. I mean, technically, even a young child should be able to master some of the basic techniques, especially if that young child has spent the best part of their life in with you in lockdown. So, without further ado, I would like to introduce you to my protege and professional lookalike. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Master Swallow! There we go, yeah. No, don't be fooled, he's actually in his early 70s. you're all right, do you want another energy drink? You're all right?
Yeah, I'm fine, thanks.
Yeah, you don't have to do the voice. you're doing great. Don't show me up. Now, look, what we've got here are some animal flashcards. There are loads here. I think there's about 50, 60 of these. And can you be honest? I'm going to mix them a bit more now, but can you be honest, Susie? You've examined these. You've been mixing these yourself as well. Because it's very, very important for everyone to realise, especially people in the audience and people at home, that this is, if it works, is real. If it works, OK? If it don't work, then it's fake. Master Swallow, you listening? Hello? I'm going to read out whatever random order these animals are in, OK? And whatever order they're in, Master Swallow, after I've done it, is going to try and attempt to recall them, but in reverse order, OK? So, here we go. Are you listening? Yeah, OK. Here we go. You're doing great. OK. Camel, crocodile, jellyfish, mantis shrimp, wolf, rhino, ground squirrel, crested gecko, scorpion, sailfish, cheetah, peregrine falcon, tiger, honeybee, giraffe. Sega antelope, don't know what that is, occupy, echidna, great great owl, kiwi, eagle, wombat, earthworm, aardvark, firefly, lemur, peacock, pufferfish, squid, skunk, snow leopard, some of these are upside down, stick insect, zebra, egg-eating snake, giant panda, listening, going in, yeah, blue whale, sea turtle, crab, armadillo, beaver, great white shark, hippo, mandrill, flamingo, chameleon, penguin, meerkat, sea otters, lion, tree frog, howler monkey, elephant, sloth, jaguar, orangutan, dolphin, puffin, walrus, albatross, koala. Now, in reverse order, Master Swallow, what was the last one I said?
Koala.
Yeah, OK. I mean, that's the easiest one, so don't, you know, don't. And then what did I say before that?
Albatross.
Yeah, and then what?
Walrus.
Yeah, and then what?
Puffin.
Yes, and then
dolphin.
What?
Dolphin.
Yes.
Orangutan.
Orangutan, yeah.
Jaguar.
Yes.
Sloth.
Yes.
Elephant.
Yes.
Howler monkey.
Yes.
Tree frog.
Yes.
Lion.
Yes.
Sea otters.
Correct.
Meerkats.
Yes.
Penguins.
Yes.
Chameleon.
Yes.
Flamingo.
Very good.
Mandrill.
Yes.
Hippo.
Yes.
Great white shark.
Yes.
And beaver.
Yeah.
Armadillo.
Yes.
Crab.
Yes.
Sea turtle.
Yes.
Blue whale.
Yes.
Giant panda.
Yes.
Egg-eating snake.
Yes.
Zebra.
Yes.
Stick insect.
Correct.
Snow leopard.
Yeah, just stop a sec. Do the next three in a row so people don't think you can see. What are the next three?
Skunk, squid, pufferfish.
Skunk, squid, pufferfish, yeah.
Peacock, lemur, firefly, aardvark, earthworm,
yes.
Wombat,
yes.
Eagle, kiwi, yes. Great grey owl, correct. Echidna,
yes.
Occupy, sega antelope, giraffe, honeybee,
yes.
Tiger,
yes.
Peregrine falcon,
yes.
Cheetah,
yes.
Sailfish.
Swims. Pardon?
Sailfish.
Correct. Scorpion. Say it again, love.
Scorpion.
Yes.
Crested gecko.
Yes.
Ground squirrel.
Yes.
Rhino.
Yes.
Wolf.
Very good.
Mantis shrimp.
Yes.
Jellyfish.
Yes.
Crocodile.
Yes.
Camel.
First one I did.
Well, can I ask, how old is that child?
That child, I believe, is...
he can't remember, can he?
Years and three quarters or something like six. Are you six and three quarters?
Six and a half.
Oh, six and a half is not as impressive. I thought it was six. that's incredible.
This is my real son, Finn.
Aww. Oh, brilliant, love.
Whoa. Who thought it wasn't his real son? who's out there going, wow, those two get along? They must just be mates. Mr. Swallow, everyone, and Master Swallow.
Master Swallow.
I'm not as proud of my achievements tonight as I should be.
Yeah, we came up with a seven-letter word.
I don't want to be big shot this or whatever, but my kid can burp on command. I like the fact that, by comparison, Rachel now looks like a bloody idiot. OK, and here is your teaser. The words are arse nuts. The clue is slowly does it. That's arse nuts, slowly does it. See you after the break. The answer to the tease. The words were arse nuts. The clue was slowly does it. It was, of course, saunters. OK, time for another letters game. Rosie and Tom are going head-to-head and we're going to up the stakes. We're playing for double points in the lightning round. Rosie, Tom, you've both been fitted with electric shock machines. At any stage, you may be shocked. So we'll just test these.
I just always worry I'm going to piss myself.
OK, Tom, you ready?
Yeah.
Brace yourself.
OK.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm sorry about that. That was... We fitted you with one by mistake.
Yeah.
This round is just for Rosie and Tom.
Oh, I enjoy it.
It tickles my nipples.
I'm going to test these one more time and then we'll play.
Yeah.
Okay, so Tom's works. Tom's works. Wow.
Do you not do it to me because of my IBS?
Yes, it is a.
That's what I thought.
It's just after last time with the whole cleanup operation. Right, there's double points up for grabs in this round. So, Tom, go ahead, pick the letters.
Consonant, please.
G.
Vowel, please. No. A consonant, please. No. A vowel, please.
Jimmy.
Say it quickly.
Consonant, please.
B.
Go not. Oh. vowel, please.
A.
Consonant.
P.
So tense.
Another consonant, please.
T.
Well played, Jimmy.
and vowel, please.
And another O.
For double points in the countdown lightning round. Your time starts now. Can you smell burning? I can smell burning and I like it.
That's my underwear.
I don't know where I am.
I can't believe you jumped out of your seat, Rosie.
Oh, what a get you up!
Okay, that's enough. I'm putting these away. That is it for shocking now. No more shocking. One more for Tom. That's it. So, how many did you get, Tom?
I got five. Tango.
Rosie, how many?
Five, but I didn't buy it. But what a different... Bongo.
Double points, because that was the lightning round. 10 points to both teams. Mr. Swallow, Susie Dent, could they have done better?
Gaboon, which is a type of hardwood tree, I believe.
So at the end of that, Joe and Rosie are in the lead with 33 points. OK, time to go across the dictionary corner once again. Mr. Swallow, what have you got for us?
So, Jimmy, I thought that I would show you a little a card trick, some little close-up magic. So I'm just going to come up there, if that's OK. And it's a very straightforward trick. So, basically, it is the three card trick. So it just uses one, two, three cards, as you might imagine. We're going to use jokers, basically. We're going to use the two jokers, and we're going to use an ace. Now, this is, you might have seen this game before, like chase the ace, or sort of three shells and like a pea underneath, and you have to move them around and try and find where it is. So the ace, we're going to pop it on top and then immediately pop it on the bottom. So, jokers on the bottom. No. So, what the magician would say is, OK, joker's on the bottom, where is the ace? Now, it's logical to think, OK, joker on the bottom, either the top or the middle is going to be the ace. So you have a look on top, top's a joker, so fine, you know that it's in, that's a joker. hang on a sec. Yeah, sorry, ace is on the bottom. Ace is on the bottom, sh Christ. The magician... God. Then says, instead of finding the ace, find the jokers, because you got more chance, right? You got twice as many odds. So now, again, logical, really easy to think. Well, ace is on the bottom, so both the top and the middle are going to be the joker. Now, the top one, you can see, is also an ace, and the middle one's... Hang on a sec. one, two, three... Sorry. OK, so, that right, there it is. There's a joker, and there's an ace. So that... No, that's a 10. worked, sorry.
Sorry. Mr. Swallow, everyone. And here is your final teaser. The words are shit rump. The clue is give me a medal. That's shit rump. Give me a medal. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the tease. The words were shit rump. The clue was give me a medal. It was, of course, triumphs. OK, time for our final letters game. Joe, Rosie, your turn to choose.
Shall we get a vowel, anyone?
Yeah.
A.
Consonant.
G.
Consonant.
N.
Consonant.
Louder.
C.
Vowel.
Louder. You're not trying hard enough.
Consonant
R.
Yeah, well done.
Consonant
S.
OK, and your 30 seconds starts now. This is perfect, appreciate it. I'll just do these. A lovely romantic dinner for two. Dirty. Yeah, I think it looks better without the tablecloth. Just check the glasses. Just give me a nice dinner, Fabio. We never take time. Why we can't have nice things. Joe, how many?
Eight.
No, you fucking haven't.
I have, yeah.
Seven.
Tom, how many?
Six.
Sarah?
Six.
Yeah, OK. Tom, what's your six?
Ranges.
Sarah, your six?
Gleans.
Rosie, your made-up seven.
It is made up. Longers.
There is just longer, obviously, but not there as a noun.
Joe, you're eight. You could save the day here with an eight.
Glances.
We all want this for you.
We do.
It's not.
Oh, yes! Yes! Yes!
6 points to Sarah and Tom.
Mr. Swallow, Susie, could they have done any better?
Yeah, well, exactly. Glances, if you swap around the G and the C, is clangers.
OK, so Joe and Rosie have 33 points. Back in the lead, Sarah and Tom with 36 points. OK, fingers on buzzers, it's time for today's crucial countdown conundrum. Your time starts now.
Mix the letters up, Tom.
Never say it. I'm gonna write it out like that.
Yes?
Gossiping.
Oh my God! It does beg the question, who are you and what have you done with Joe Wilkinson? Congratulations, Joe and Rosie, you're now the proud owner of this, the Countdown Jazz Band Kit! Yeah! Thanks to all of our panelists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night!